absolutely nothing. You could say just material exists. And then a few chemicals get together. Then a few more chemicals with longer chains, longer polymers, which are today called as proteins. These proteins get together and they form a soupy, silky substance called the protoplasm. What do they form? The protoplasm. This protoplasm still is inert. It has no consciousness. But given the way these chemicals, these molecules have come together, this protoplasm starts developing something which is not totally inert. It learns a way to respond to the environment. And slowly, gradually, your first single-celled organism is born. Relatives of that are today called by the name of amoeba, paramecium, and such names. This amoeba too remains single-celled for a long period of time. Right? And then it learns to multiply. More complex organisms start coming into existence. And how does it learn to multiply? By again responding to environment. Why? The amoeba knows nothing. All that it is doing is a response to its environment. It is absorbing everything from the environment. As a result of its environment, it wants to grow bigger. It grows bigger. Complex tissues are formed. Then from that, as a response again to the environment, more complex creatures are formed. Specialization starts taking place. Things called eyes start forming. Other sensory organs start forming. So much so that the organism not only now responds to the environment, it also changes the environment. It starts finding safe places for itself, and if it can't find, it starts creating safe places by hiding beneath a rock, by moving a stone or two. Are you getting it? It keeps assimilating from the environment, responding to the environment. And slowly, birds and reptiles, and then you have monkeys and apes, and finally we come to this creature that you today call the man. This story is the story of evolution. This story is the story of our body. And the most important part of this body, which contains all the other parts of this body, is called the brain. This essentially is the story of the development of our brain. How from nothing it has come to this point, and how many years has it taken? Millions of years. So the brain is nothing but the experiences gathered over these millions of years. Time. And whatever experiences it is gathering in space, something is happening in space. Brain is, write down, brain is time and space. Brain is time and space. All of you have studied physics. Have you ever bothered to ask? And you know, most physical quantities can be expressed in MLT. Have you ever bothered to ask what is L, what is T? What is time, tell me? What is time?
It is a fabric of space. Fabric of space.
And what is space? What is space time? Because of course, these two are inseparable. They both are inseparable. What are they? What is space time?
Everything around us. Basically, each and every.
What are you then? You can't give a roundabout answer again. What is space time? And why do you want to bring yourself in between? When I ask you, for example, what is a coulomb? Do you bring yourself in between? What is space time? You have just written that down. What have you written down?
Brain.
Time and space are properties of the human brain or brain. It is not somewhere there, it is here. Time and space are here. The brain itself is time and space. All that it can perceive is time and space. It is a product of time and space and it perceives only time and space. It will sound a little strange to you initially. The brain is nothing but time and space. Time fills it up. What is time? Change. How do you know time is passing? When something changes in space, that's why these two are interlinked. That's what all those experiences in time and in space have made this brain. Otherwise, it is nothing. Every single cell of the brain comes from that past.